Hey everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today I want to discuss how caffeine or energy drinks or these pre-workout stimulants, just stress overall, how they affect your testosterone and hormone levels. Now, a little while ago I made a video entitled "The Truth About Exercise, Does It Increase or Decrease Testosterone Levels?" And I highly suggest you watch that video if you exercise, whether it's with weights and or cardio, but I'll give you that special link at the end of today's video. Now, an important question that was asked from that video that was posted in the comment section was by someone. They asked, "I take pre-workout stimulants. How do those products affect my testosterone levels? I am stronger at the gym because of it. Does that mean it's increasing my testosterone levels? What about adrenaline, good or bad?" So this is a good question. This is actually a great question because I know a lot of people who do take pre-workout stimulants or basically different products that will give them more energy, such as, you know, energy drinks. Unfortunately, almost all these products are just loaded with caffeine. Sure, they'll have, you know, some vitamins and amino acids just thrown in there for looks, but honestly, it's all about the caffeine. That's their main moneymaker. It's the primary ingredient that's basically doing it all. That's causing the stimulation of your adrenal glands to produce more adrenaline and epinephrine. Now, speaking of epinephrine, you know, in the old days, we used to take actually ephedrine, which is basically an amphetamine. Again, they're very similar. So when taking such stimulants, whether they're pre-workout pills, energy drinks, or, you know, anything with caffeine, your body produces more adrenaline and epinephrine, which triggers your body's what's called the fight or flight response. I'm sure you heard of it. Now, this causes the air passages to dilate and open up more, which provides your muscles with a lot more energy and oxygen. Obviously, this is great for exercise. At the same time, adrenaline causes your blood vessels to get smaller and contract, but they do this to redirect more blood towards your muscles, including your heart and lung. This is one reason that your heart rate speeds up and your blood pressure goes up with stimulants. The end result is you actually feel less pain, so you can push longer and harder, which again is perfect when you're exercising or when you're trying to run for your life. You'll also become stronger and have heightened awareness. Again, all of this is great for exercise. Of course, with the good, you gotta take the bad, and there is a problem with all this. Unfortunately, your body's fight or flight response is not to be triggered daily. This is massive stress on the body. This causes a huge surge and an increase in stress hormones such as cortisol. Now, keep in mind that exercise in and of itself will cause an increase in adrenaline and cortisol. These stimulant products are now adding to this stress. This is extra stress. So now that's double the stress on your body and your endocrine system, your hormones. This is a bad thing. However, that's just the beginning of the negativity. These days, most people already have adrenal fatigue due to an overproduction of adrenaline. Our lives are very complicated now than compared to, you know, 50, 100 years ago and so forth. We're getting bombarded with, you know, stuff all day long and being pulled in different directions all the time, which again is very stressful. Which is why we feel overwhelmed and unmotivated. Your phone alone is a massive stressor. Driving and that, you know, all that goes along with it, another massive stressor. We have more responsibilities and information coming at us all day long, from the first thing in the morning all the way till bedtime. We work more and longer hours, and yet we are actually sleeping less and less deeply. Thus, your nervous and adrenal system does not have time to recover properly, let alone fully. People don't even realize this because we're just now used to this. We just tolerate it. So what does this all mean for you? Well, most people have elevated levels of stress hormones. Every time I've done blood tests on people, it's always shown high. And saliva tests as well. Now, some people have it so bad that it has just burnt out their adrenal glands, and thus they need stimulants such as caffeine and coffee just to feel normal and get through the day. Now, all of this now causes a massive hormonal imbalance, and thus more stress hormones such as cortisol ends up causing a decrease in both total and free testosterone levels. Remember, the opposite of testosterone is not the female hormone estrogen, but the stress hormone cortisol. Prolonged stress also causes negative changes in other key hormones, such as insulin, growth hormones, IGF, prolactin, thyroid, and so forth. Now, all of these will cause negative changes in how you look and feel. This basically means less muscle and more fat. You'll also have less motivation and drive, including in the bedroom, and thus lowered libido and potentially erectile problems for guys. Now, the bottom line here is that you want to manage stress levels and not add to them. Taking pre-workout stimulants, you know, energy drinks and coffee and caffeine and all these other products that have caffeine and similar compounds adds to an already stressed body. Yes, you'll feel, you know, short-term increase in performance, but the price will be decreased in long-term results. Remember, you want to lower stress levels, not add to them, not increase them. So if any of today's video makes sense to you, if you're tired or you need, you know, caffeine products just to feel normal, have a good workout. If you feel maybe your testosterone levels aren't where they should be, if you're not as motivated or happy or excited about life, then one potential cause is just overstress. Now it's time that you need to heal your body, and I've put two links below in the description area. One is about improving your testosterone hormone levels so you can actually build more muscle, lose fat, and have better sex drive. It's about balancing it out. There's a second link about improving your energy levels and memory and cognition without the use of stimulants such as caffeine. You'll help actually repair your adrenal glands and fatigue, so it's a good thing. Make sure you share the health and let other people know about this video and today's topic so they can benefit as well. Thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.